about a horse, the grace and rhythm of his step, the proud set of his head, the spirit of friendship in his eyes. He is poetry in motion, power and beauty on four legs. What finer sight is there than a well-trained horse in motion? Let it then be said again, for truer words were never spoken. There's something about a horse, a warmth of kinship between man and beast, a spirit that flows unseen, but certain as the fact of life itself. From the loins of the rider to the flanks of the moving mount, from the fingertips and the reins to the head and heart of the animal under control. This is the story of the Tennessee Walking Horse, a relatively new breed in the matter of registration, but today firmly established among the hierarchy of horses. The Tennessee Walking Horse, known wherever men find delight in the use and companionship of horse flesh, as the world's greatest pleasure horse. A proud claim, that, but a claim substantiated every day in town and country, in stable and paddock, in the arena of show exhibition and competition, and on trails and bridle paths throughout the length and breadth of this land of ours. This nationwide badge of approval is based on a sound and lasting foundation, derived from inheritance, selection, and environment. It was the alchemy of these basic factors through more than a century's time that bred the free and easy gaits, the symmetry of form, the docile disposition, the high intelligence, the endurance, and general usefulness that today make the Tennessee Walking Horse the favorite of pleasure riders of all ages. To trace the genealogy of this animal, turn back the pages of history to the formative years of our country, when his equine ancestors developed the bloodline qualities and characteristics that are his heritage today. And years when what is now the state of Tennessee was a trackless wilderness. The first white settlers of Middle Tennessee, cradle of the breed, came on horseback, bringing with them, for work to be done as well as riding, a hardy stock of saddle horses. They made their way across the mountains from Virginia and the Carolinas, with a Bible in one hand and a rifle in the other, fearing God and ever watchful of hostile Indians, but determined to make a home for themselves in this new land. Here in the bluegrass section of Middle Tennessee, where feed and pasture grew on a soil rich in lime and phosphorus minerals, food elements ideal for solid bone structure, this new horse had his beginnings, born to walk and nod, a way of going clothed in beauty. When Tennessee was young in the sisterhood of states, this was the horse that took the circuit rider to crude houses of worship, where he preached the gospel to his fellow men. This was the horse that took children to school, over mountains and through forests, to pioneer schoolhouses in a clearing, miles from the houses and cabins of the new pioneer settlers. And then, when the school day was over, brought these children safely home again. This was the horse that took the housewife in calico dress and sunbonnet to the general store, with a basket of eggs in one hand and a baby on her left, and with another child or two hanging on behind, all delivered safe and sound, with not an eggshell cracked and not a child bruised or missing. This was the horse with the stamina to pull a loaded wagon over primitive roads, through dense woods and over rugged hills, and still have enough left to do his full share of work on the farm. This then is the horse born of necessity, improved in his way of going by 125 years of careful breeding. The Tennessee Walking Horse of today averages around 15 and a half hands in height, and in weight will vary between 1,000 and 1,200 pounds. Ruggedness and great stamina should be without any trace of coarseness in appearance or manner. This beautiful animal represents top confirmation of the Tennessee walking horse as a breed. The head is intelligent and neat. The ears well-shaped and pointed. Good big bright eyes and tapering muzzle. The neck is long and graceful, set on well-muscled sloping shoulders, of good proportion and width in the chest. The hide is tough. Hair soft and silky. In general conformation, the Tennessee walking horse is short in the back, deep in the body, and well ribbed. Muscled legs with flat bone. Sound feet of ample size to combat lameness. Full in the flanks with good flat hips. The tail is long and full. In disposition, the Tennessee walking horse is gentle and easily handled, a result of his almost constant contact with human beings through the years. It is this companionable nature that makes him especially adaptable to use by inexperienced riders, by women and children, and by older persons, wherever pleasure horses are enjoyed and wherever there is pride in their ownership. Wherever men get together for a session of lively horse talk, it is known that the Tennessee walking horse is famous for his three free and easy gaits, distinctive characteristics of the breed. First, the flat foot walk, slowest of the three gaits, with a speed of from 3 to 4 miles an hour. A diagonally opposed movement of the feet, as seen here, a two-measure beat and a 1-2 order. Right front and left rear. Left front and right rear. Note the bold gait in perfect symmetry. Here is ease and grace, allowing comfortable carriage to the rider. The running walk, a gait peculiar to this breed. Faster in movement, from 6 to 8 miles an hour. This gait starts like the flat foot walk. As speed increases, this first gait seems to melt into the running walk, going from 4 and 5 miles an hour up to 6, 7, and 8. Here is the running walk in slow motion. Note the free and easy floating style of going. The jar or jolt of the horse's back is eliminated by the light spring of its legs, the motion of its feet. It is this gait that gives the rider the wonderful impression of gliding through the air. It is the only gait of a horse where the forefoot strikes the ground a mere instant before the hind foot. Here it is. Note the forefoot at the instant of striking ground, with the hind foot still off the ground. And there he goes, in the sweetest gait in all horsedom. A diagonally opposed movement, with hind foot overstepping the front track from 6 to 24 inches at each forward stride. The third and fastest of the three gaits is the canter, with plenty of spring and rhythm, yet with a minimum of jar or jolt to the rider, as can be clearly seen in slow motion. Note the easy rise and fall movement, a kind of refined gallop, not too fast, with a rolling motion that has become known as the rocking chair movement, making the canter a gait that is graceful, easy, and executed naturally. So natural are the gaits that the young of the breed, usually foaled in the spring, do them from birth. Foals are seen to walk with all the ease of older horses, while they are yet by the sides of their dams. Put under the saddle saddle at 2 years of age, walkers require no arduous period of training, going the free and easy gaits in a comparatively short time. These comfortable riding gaits have become fixed characteristics of the breed, for in most instances, Tennessee walking horses are natural walkers, doing what comes natural with no need for bitting or spurring to properly execute their gaits. In Lewisburg, Tennessee, stands a building dedicated to the welfare and improvement of the Tennessee walking horse as a distinctive breed. This is the home of the Tennessee Walking Horse Breeders Association of America, founded on May 25th, 1935. Through the offices of the association, careful attention is given to the gathering and dissemination of information and new knowledge having to do with the Tennessee walking horse. Here they are carefully registered and pedigrees are collected, recorded, and preserved.
The Tennessee Walking Horse National Celebration. Attention, exhibitors. Have your horses ready.
The climactic event of the year for lovers of the walking horse and for those who find pleasure and excitement in horse flesh of any and all breeds, the Tennessee Walking Horse National Celebration, held every year in Shelbyville, Tennessee, during the first week in September, with exhibitions and events taking place during the day and evening. Here, from all sections of the United States, are gathered the cream of the crop, the finest and best horses of the walking breed, competing on an equal footing for honor, cash, and glory. Here, too, is a cordial invitation to horse lovers the world over to participate in an annual event that is a fitting tribute to the Tennessee walking horse, held on his native soil, the bluegrass region of Middle Tennessee. The Tennessee Walking Horse National Celebration, the world's largest walking horse show. Year by year, a bigger and better show than the year before. More people, old and young alike. More and better horses. Aged and young things. More things to see, keener competition, greater excitement. More conscientious judging in the arena. And the final estimates of form, manners, and performance that combine to earn acclaim as champion.
Judges, ready. Lady and gentlemen riders, ready.
The best of their respective classes. End results of the tender care and expert training. Carrying into competition the cherished hopes and aspirations of their owners and trainers. Here are some of the great stallions which are famous sires of the breed. And here are some of the great dams which are renowned producers of the breed. Here is keen competition among breeders, testing their judgment in crossings. The selection of proper stallions to nick with the blood of their brood mares, to the end of producing the finest in young horse flesh.
Winner of the main event of the celebration, judging for the grand champion walking horse of the world, and now presenting the...
And so the show goes on, coming to a fitting climax on the last night, with a selection of the grand champion of the world.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we take pleasure in presenting the champion walking horse of the world.
Breeders of the Tennessee Walking Horse have been and are still making a close study of bloodlines and crossings, seeking the best sires for mating with their dams, guided by the basic laws of genetics, the experience of the past, and the ever-increasing demand for the constant improvement of the breed. The walking horse of today has a clean, flat bone, abundance of muscles, sound feet, neat, intelligent head, solid power and strength in his back and loins. He is the horse that makes sweet music with his iron-shod feet on the good earth, in a rhythm entirely his own, as he glides along in a running walk, nodding his head, his chin about level with his chest, a symphony of sweet sound and a spectacle of rare beauty. There is no labor or exertion in handling this gentle-mannered animal that responds so readily to light reining. There is but one way to ride him. Just mount and relax. No posting, no weight in the stirrups beyond the need for balance. Ride with medium loose rein. Enjoy the helpful recreation of sitting the saddle on the back of this gentleman of the equine. A salute, then, to this walking horse. His fine form, his docile disposition, his sterling performance in the free and easy gait. From his place of origin in the bluegrass region of Middle Tennessee, he has gone out to all sections of our land, taking his place as the greatest of pleasure horses, on bridle paths and open trails, and as a sturdy workhorse on ranch, farm, and plantation. To the pleasure rider, old and young, for the new and inexperienced, man, woman, and child, there is no finer mount, no greater thrill of satisfaction in the saddle than the rocking chair movement of the Tennessee walking horse. Truly is it said of these great animals, if you ride one today, you will own one tomorrow.